Hello everyone, and welcome back. If you guys have been following the videos or following the Joe and Zach Survival and Northern Seclusion Facebook page, you know that I picked up a disc for behind the tractor. I just got it pulled off the trailer here a couple of minutes ago. I had to lift it off with the tractor, hooked it up to the tractor, and it looks pretty good. All the parts are here. None of the discs look to be bent. All of these scrapers are in place. Somebody had said to make sure to look at it and make sure there's not a lot of welding or anything where something broke. I don't really see anything except for this right here, and I don't know if that's from the factory because it has green paint over it, and I know this thing certainly doesn't look like it's been painted over, you know, since it was new from the factory. It still has the KVA on there. Originally when I bought it, they said it did not have the hydraulic cylinder, and then when I showed up to pick it up, the son was selling this for the dad, and then the dad showed up, and in his barn he had a John Deere cylinder right there. It's a little bit bigger than what is needed for this. I mean, it'll work just fine. It's just bigger than what I would have needed. But it's even an original John Deere, so that would have been quite expensive, and he let me have it for $50. You'll see the picking it up trip and everything on the farmhouse video that is being filmed right now, which is, there's still one that has to be uploaded before that. But anyway, eventually you'll see it. I just wanted to show it in a little bit more detail. Tires aren't in the best shape. It did come with one extra tire. And he had said that these rims here didn't match up. This one compared to this one, but I see absolutely no difference in the two. But he did give me the original one that came with it. And again, I don't see any difference in it, but I'll look at them closer. But anyway, I have an extra tire. I think I'm gonna go ahead and grease this up, see if the Zerx will take any grease. And I do have the cylinder, but I am gonna get new hoses made. I can make it so that the hoses just come up to the tractor here. And then I unhook my three-point hitch, and I could run it off that same lever, which is this one right here. And I might do that, or I may get longer hoses, and I have a spot here where if I buy one of the levers, I can just put the fittings right up here. I'm gonna have to take this light and move it back maybe a half an inch. And then I would have its own, it would have its own separate lever for that, and then anything else that I would hook up on the back of the tractor could run off of this lever also. And then I would never have to unhook the three-point. I'll have to look up and see how that hooks up. To me, that seems like that could just pop right out of there, so I'm sure I have something wrong. And then once I get the hoses, I can extend this out because it has to reach up into here, and that'll raise and lower the disc. You can find quite a few old discs that don't have the hydraulic lift option on there, but I didn't want that. I actually have one at the hobby farmhouse back in the woods that's an 8-footer. It's nothing like this. I mean, it's pretty rickety, but it did the trick when I had to do the yard at the house that I lived in next door to that one when we built that house. I disced the whole yard and then drug it and then laid sod. And it worked good. The problem is when you're going to move it around, anywhere you drive it, you've got the disc, whatever, you know, the blades there running on the ground, and I didn't want to do that here. This is just so much easier to... Plus, you can't just move it. With this one here, you can almost push it by hand to move it around. Nope, I cannot get one fitting to take grease. Probably hasn't been greased, and I think these were built in the 50s. Probably hasn't seen grease since the 50s. Oh, that one is the first one. The only one. I don't think there's... There might be some up front we can try, but... Oh, that one takes it too. Okay, everyone. Well, thanks a lot for watching. All of the sections of disc seem to spin really good. This one right here spins good and has one tight spot. I mean, it still spins through it. I don't know. I think if I actually unscrewed that like a half a turn, it wouldn't be that way, but we'll see how it works. And I'll try to get the old Zerk fittings off and put new ones on. I don't know how that's gonna go, but anyway, the farmhouse has a disc. I will see you guys on the next video.